All right, y'all. So, are y'all excited to be here today?
Yes.
Are y'all excited to worship God today?
Yes.
If you're excited, clap one time. If you're excited, clap two times. If you're excited, stand up. If you're excited, clap one time. If you're excited, clap two times. Awesome. I hope y'all ready because it's going to be a great mass. Same time. Hey, Miss Alvin. Hey, Miss Alvin. Well. I got some stories y'all I'm going to share with y'all today. So, instantly, y'all don't have a seat. Y'all, this is going to be so awesome. We're going to have a ball. We're going to have fun. We're going to worship God. And the question I want you to ask yourself throughout this mass, and I want y'all to remember this. What did Jesus say? What did Jesus say? Can y'all repeat that to me?
What did Jesus say?
One more time, let me hear you.
What did Jesus say?
By the way, I'm very interactive. I will come down the aisle for you. I'm just like that. Don't worry about it. We're going to have fun. Y'all pay attention. And let's worship God. Sounds like a plan? If you want to worship God, clap one time. Worship God, clap two times. Thank you. See y'all soon.
Mr. Parker gave you a whole 7-minute introduction, but he used only 3 minutes, so we still have a few more minutes. Just before we start, just want to introduce you a young lady here in trouble with Mr. Parker, Avera from Alabama. She studied at the university here, Franciscan University, so welcome her. Thank you very much for coming. And she studied theology. She studied about church, about liturgy, about spirituality. So you might see her face, and she might come over here and entertain you and help you with touring and all that. Okay, so remember her name and her face. Now, I also have a few more questions because I'm preparing religion classes for you guys, especially right now, 5th grade and 8th grade. A little bit about God, about prayer, about Mass. Now, we go to Mass quite often, yes, every week. And I don't know if you have any question about Mass, but when I read about Mass for you guys, it's a lot of questions. Do you know why we're wearing green? This is called vestment. Why we wear green and not red and not purple. How many colors did Father Ted wear during Mass? Do you remember? We just name it. A few colors. Green,
purple,
white, and red. Very good. Green for when? What the name for green here? For army time means that when we in green, like our color, you know, Redemptorist, St. Jerry School, our color is green. For honorary time means regular time. Purple when? We almost wear purple now. Next week when you come back?
For Lent.
Very good. And for Advent. Very good, very close. Advent. Okay, so Lent is coming up and Father Ted will wear purple, okay? How about white? When do we wear white vestment? Anybody? For Easter?
Easter.
Right? For Mary, when we have a celebration, for Mary, we put white on, okay? the martyrs, saints. The martyrs, you know why we wear red for the martyrs? People, the saints that they sacrifice their life for the faith, chop the head, chop the limbs, you know, kill in prison because they shed blood for the faith. That's why blood stands for like red. So that's why the priests wear red vestment. Yes? So now we have 1 minute. Just pause yourself, put yourself together, and remember, we come here to praise God. So if you have any petition, prayer that you want to pray for, today we have a lot of rains and cold weather. Remember those who still living outside, they have no home, yes? Homeless. People who are very poor, their roof is leaking, and the water, a lot of water leaking through their roof. So remember those people in our prayer, yes? Yeah, bad accident because of the icy roads, it's a lot. Okay, so we thank God that we are here. And we also thank God that next week you have to, don't have to come back until when?
Thursday.
Long vacation. Yes? So we thank God for everything we have. And we thank God for Mr. Michael Parker to be here with us. And let us celebrate. Do we have song today? Yes? Please stand. that to be, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated and listen to the word of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee into the district of how they did calories. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment, begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spit in, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be open." And immediately the man's ears were open. His speech impediment was removed and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they complained. They were exceedingly astonished and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Please be seated.
So I was very happy for Father Taz to actually ask him to come and speak to y'all today. Just with me hearing him over the phone and having a conversation with him, he was really passionate about y'all. Like, you could just tell that he had this fatherly care for each and every one of you. And it really warmed my heart just to hear him talk about that to you. So it's really an honor for me, though, because especially this is where I grew up. It wasn't in particular this church, but this neighborhood, this area of the world, zip code. This is my home. So to be able to come here and actually give you words and to motivate you and to hope that you leave your relationship with Jesus Christ is truly an honor for me. So, thinking about it, before I go into it, by a show of hands, how many of y'all love to listen to music? Y'all like listening to music? Y'all like music? What kind of music do y'all like? Country? No country? Y'all like rock music? Blues? Like blues a little bit? Rhythm and blues? R&B? Hip hop, rap, you like rap? So look, I like rap too, right? So there's like these different artists that I kind of, you know, relate to a little bit. Like, who is his name? Champagne Poppy, you know, Drake. Drizzy Drake. Got him. Got Cardi B, what's that voice she makes? Oh, her. Let me see that. Do it for me. How's it going? Oh, her. There it is. Do it again? Oh, her. Okay, like that, right? You got Bad News Challenge, you got NBA Young Boy, Roddy Rich, those type of artists, right? So the thing is, let's be honest with ourselves. When we're listening to them, do we feel that we are able to play that music around our parents, our teachers, and probably not, right? Maybe it's because like we all have this internal thing within us and we know that some of the things that are talked about are not for the natural good. And it's not downplaying that they are beloved sons and daughters of God. But maybe some of the things that are talked about is not putting us towards a way of going towards our good. But the thing is, we open ourselves up to listen to that. We open ourselves up to listen to that because if a new album drops, if you're like me, I go to Apple Music immediately or Spotify, make sure that I'm open to hear everything that they have to say. It sounds like something y'all do too. Y'all do the same thing? Y'all hear me?
Yes,
please. I'm in, right? Y'all want to come further down? Come to you? Y'all cool? I want y'all to see. So look, here's the thing. So we open ourselves up to that. We open ourselves up to listening to that type of thing. But this is the thing. As of right now, this month, in the United States of America, we observe something special this month. What is it? Black History Month, right? So we think about the civil rights leaders, these African Americans that have gone before us, that have contributed so much to our country, so much to our culture. And it's things like that we probably don't open ourselves up to as much. Say, for instance, W.E.B. Du Bois. He was an American author. Like, he wrote plenty of literature, plenty of books that was to empower his brothers and sisters. And he used his intellect. then we have the civil rights leader that we just celebrated a holiday maybe a little less than a month ago. What was his name? I can't hear you. What's his name? Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., right? And Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was someone that embraced Christianity. Christianity so that he can be open to what it is that the world was telling him, so that he can have a revelation. So my question to each and every one of you here, and I hope y'all look at me in my eyes when I'm asking this. Each and every one of you, are you open to the good news? Are you open to the word of God? Are you open to the gospel? In today's gospel, we hear of this deaf man who had a speech impediment who came to Jesus. People brought him to Jesus. And once he was brought to him, Jesus healed him, putting his hands on him, he looks up and he says, Ephphatha, be open. Be open. And from that point, he was healed. He no longer was deaf. He could hear. And he no longer had a speech impediment. He could speak clearly. All because people brought him to have an encounter with Jesus. He was able to have a relationship with him. Our church teaches that God desires, he desires to be in an intimate relationship with each and every one of you. But the thing is, we have to be open. We just said earlier that we're open to listening to some of the things that's not for our natural good. But the thing is, we just want to be open to our will. Y'all are not here by accident. Each student in this school, you are not here by accident. You probably have friends that they don't learn about Jesus on a daily basis. They don't come to Mass, the holy sacrifice of the Mass, which is the highest form of worship that you can do in the world, on here on earth. The highest form of worship is to celebrate the Mass. But you have to be open to that. You have to be open to the graces that the Lord is going to give you so that you can have a divine revelation. And just like in the first reading, you hear Adam and Eve. They were open, but what were they persuaded by? Who was they persuaded by? The serpent, right? The serpent made them what? Eat the fruit. He ate the fruit. So the serpent talked to them and got them to do that. And they were open to that, but it caused them to go against God's command. But being open to God's grace, so we can have divine revelation to hold the way. Just thinking about it, you have to be Ray Charles to that. Y'all get that? Ray Charles to that? You have to be blind to that noise on the outside that's actually telling you that this isn't what you need. God is what you need. God is what you need each and every moment of your life. So, think about this. Dr. Martin Luther King and his revelation going through all that turmoil and hatred that he was going through, he was able to see that you didn't have to fight violence with violence. One of his great lines was, darkness doesn't get away or take away darkness. Only light can do that. Lumen Christi, the light of Christ, that's the only thing that can get rid of darkness. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. So, little brothers and sisters, as I'm looking at y'all, as knowing that I was in this position, I was in your shoes, I'm asking you, be open. As Jesus said, be open. Let his words pierce your hearts, let his words guide you so that you can become who God intended you to be, so that you can do his will and make disciples of all nations. Can y'all do that? Can y'all do that?
Yes.
One more time, I gotta make sure y'all hear with me. Can y'all do that?
Yes.
Praise God. Let's do it.
Blessed are you, Lord, out of creation, with your goodness we have received this bread to offer you. For the earth will be given hands, it will be come for us, the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And blessed are you, Lord, out of creation, with your goodness we have received this wine to offer you. Through the Bible, we give given hands, it will become for us the Spirit of you. Blessed be God forever. For I, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. The Lord be with you.
And
with
your spirit.
Lift
up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and just. It is truly right and just, our only salvation, always and everywhere give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him, through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominion, adore, and power tremble before you. Now in the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim, worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we are played. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please be seated. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, and Ron, our bishop, and all Remember also our brothers and sisters, especially those who mentioned this Mass. We have fallen asleep in a hope resurrection, and all we have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, who is spouse of the Blessed Apostles, St. Jerry, and all the saints that have lived throughout the ages, will be married to you for heirs to eternal life, and may mercy glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, in the name of God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lamb of God. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we give another round of applause.
Open.
There you go. One more time.
Be
open.
One more time.